And an election standing by the reliability of the automated counting machines that will be used in next year's polls, as well as the company behind it. The commission also unveiling a new batch of policies that aim to instill discipline among candidates. Sherian Torres reports.
Right now. Commission on Elections Chairman George Irvin Garcia demonstrated how automated counting machine will be used in next year's polls during AMAC voting at ANC program Head Start. ABS-CBN anchor Karen Davila was asked to fill a ballot paper, which was later fed to the ACM. The ACM then showed the list of candidates she voted for. It later released a voting receipt with a QR code, which needs to be dropped to the voting receipt receptacle. Garcia says the voter or the poll watcher are not allowed to take a photo of the accomplished ballot or voting receipt. Doing so opens them up to possible charges. On election day, a voter will be able to see an image of the ballot flashed on the screen. Poll officials also rule out the possibility of a fake or pre-filled ballots being fed to the machine.
Sa simula pa lang, gagawin po ng ating teachers, una papakita yung ballot box sa MP, ilalagay yung takip. Pag na-mount ka po yung makina, nare-zero siya and all, lahat po yan ay sa-cellular. So hindi na po tatanggalin yan. Bubuksan na lamang, bubibreak open ng seal na yan kapag pinatawag po ng korte o ng COMELEC sa isang election protest. Hindi po yan gagalawin, hindi yan babalihin unless may order po ang komisyon o kaya po ang mga korte.
Meantime, Garcia dismisses criticisms hurled against South Korean firm Miro System. The poll chief maintains the technology firm was able to meet their demands and the company showed it can deliver the needed machines. This comes after COMELEC officials and other stakeholders inspected Miro's factory in South Korea. Miro Systems, for its part, says they will continue to show transparency as they move forward with their responsibility for the upcoming elections. Meantime, the COMELEC and Bank has approved the proposal directing candidates in the 2025 midterm elections to only use biodegradable materials for their campaign paraphernalia. Candidates are also prohibited from using loud communication systems and other hazardous materials in their campaign activities.
The sense is there has to be a sanction. We will see if it's going to be workable that it's part either of the certificate of candidacy, or if not, then it is a pledge that we are going to put up at the filing that, you know, we'll ask them to sign, or it's available for them to sign voluntarily. So in that sense, also call it a soft law, you know. People, it will be enforced by what? By publicity, and people publicly will see, does this candidate support this initiative by signing or not? And that will impact also on his environmental bona fides for the public.
Eco-Waste Coalition and Environmental Protection Watchdog welcomed the commission's policy, saying they have long been advocating for environment-friendly elections.
Dahil may bagong nilabas na advisory nga ang COMELEC, ay maaari at mas magandang tignan na parang randomly ay titignan natin kung sino talaga yung sumusunod at hindi sumusunod at call out natin yung pangalan na yan.
The Commission and Bank also gives its green light to post on the COMELEC website the certificates of candidacy and certificates of nomination and acceptance, or CONA, of all national and local candidates in next year's elections. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
Meralco issued refunds to its customers amounting to over 40 billion pesos last March. But as Alvin El Chico tells us, a former commissioner of the Energy Regulatory Commission believes the power distributor owes even more.
A former commissioner of the Energy Regulatory Commission maintains that Meralco needs to refund more than 100 billion pesos despite a recent ERC decision that dismissed motions questioning Meralco's rate. Alfredo Non says Meralco's current average rate of 1 peso and 35 centavos per kilowatt hour should be down to just a little over 1 peso per kilowatt hour based on his computation.
Yun pa rin ang paninindigan ko hanggang ngayon. 160 billion. Pero nagbayad ng Meralco, inutusan ng ERC na magbayad ng 48 billion. So may natitira pang 112 billion.
Non says his group, as well as other petitioners, will go to a higher court to reverse the recent ERC decision. ERC Chairperson Mona Lisa Di Malanta and Commissioner Catherine Maceda dissented from the majority.
Responsibilidad nila na itama yung mali. Hindi ko mo nag-decide yung tatlo na wala na yung motion for reconsideration, hindi na nila pwedeng galawin yung mali.
Meralco, for his part, claims Non's computation has no basis since the ERC had already decided on the matter and the utility shelled out more than 40 billion pesos in refund.
Parang sinabi niya, wag na lang kaming kumita. Diba? Noong panahon ng lapse period na yon, yung 7 taon. Eh kung kukwentahin mo yung kinita mo, ang total lang yun eh, yung amount na pinare-refund niya. So ano bang gusto niya hindi kumita yung distribution utility dahil sa kanyang mali-maling kalkulasyon.
Meralco also questions Non's motive since he should have acted on the rate issue when he was still a commissioner.
Siya ang oversight commissioner ng mga panahon na yan. Diba? Kung sa tingin niya talaga tama at pinaniindigan niya yung sinasabi niya na tama at totoo, bakit hindi niya ginawa ng panahon niya? Diba? Meron bang order sa kanya na hindi gawin yon? Ba't di niya ginawa? Diba? Kung ibig sabihin lang yun, alam niyang walang pupuntahan yun dahil alam niyang mali.
But for ERC Commissioner Maseda, the majority should have considered Non's computation versus the current average rate of Meralco.
A difference of 0.37. Huh? Yeah. And will that not compel you, Alvin, if you were a member of the commission, to grant the MR and revisit the numbers, at the very least, revisit the numbers? Hindi ba? Parang ang laki kasi, hindi naman biro-biro.
Maseda says even Meralco's almost 15% weighted average cost of capital versus the lower percentage recommended by an expert should have been considered by the majority.
Very glaring eh. Kaya yun, balik ako sa tanong mo. Ito ba, meron ba itong implikasyon sa mga consumers? Napakalaki po ng implikasyon nito.
Commissioners who sided with the majority decision refused to talk about the issue. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.